Hello. I'm going to take you into a PHP deep dive, so bear with me. First, a little bit about myself, showing my age here a little bit, doing security for about 20 years, 11 years as a consultant, and actually been using MISP now for 5 years. I realized I've been at all the MISP summits up to date. It's grown quite a lot. It's good to see. I'm actually working at the National Cybersecurity Center at the Netherlands at the moment, where we use MISP extensively. That's my GitHub handle. That's my avatar. And on the big list that Alexander showed, that's me. So I've been doing commits since 2015. Minor improvements, bug fixes. And I'm going to talk here too about a fix I did, an issue I found recently. That's my Twitter handle. Not using it that much. Also started Nader MISP for people using MISP in the Netherlands. Not very active at the moment, but we should get that going. So hit me up on Twitter, or we can start something in the Netherlands as well. Okay, so I'm going to talk to you about synchronization within MISP. Basically, two MISP servers connected, sharing information using the MISP syncing protocol. There's a few ways for syncing data. The first one is the British obvious one. When you publish an event and you click on that button, it's pushed to the other side. And of course, you can also do it using the servers. You can do it manually, clicking the button, or you can do it through a schedule. And that works both ways. You can push and pull using those lists of servers. So how does that actually work? When you press the alert button, press the submit button, you can choose either submitting with or without email. So depending on that, you call that function, and then the email is sent, then the event is published, and that actually happens through a background job nowadays. And when it's published, it goes through the ZeroMQ to the Kafka, and then eventually it will upload it to the service as well. And it goes through the pushing rules that you might have set up, and then eventually it is sent to the server, and then after that the proposals are synced as well to the server. So that's the whole routine that's happening there. So this is when you manually push the publish button. It's pretty similar when it's uploaded to the server. What actually happens is it calls a post to the event endpoint on that server. And interestingly enough, when that event already exists, a 404 is returned. I was looking through the code, and that actually was fixed to a 302, which is normal. But then somehow it changed back. So it's still 404 today. And then another event is made to the right location if the event already exists. So that's basically the end of it. It's just two HTTP requests that happen, and then the data is sent across. So when you go to the server list and you press a button there to upload data, it basically is the same thing, except it goes through the server controller first, and then eventually it still calls the upload event to server. It goes through all the events that need to be pushed manually and sends them all across. And then if it's scheduled, it's basically the same thing as this page, only it's called from a scheduler on the time that you set. It's gonna call that function periodically. So pulling, there's no manual pull for an event. There is a manual copy. When you go into viewing of a remote server, you can pull it down. But pulling from a server, it's basically done either by manually pushing the pull button or doing a schedule. And this is where we found the logic issue. Because what happens is that when you press a button or when the schedule goes off, an index, minimal index, what it's called, is pulled down, and from that index, it's determined which events need to be pulled in. So it's calling event index, and then it checks if the events that are in that index are newer, so it removes the older ones, and then it checks if there's a blacklist for those events, and then it starts pulling down those events for each event. Yeah. So what happens inside that pull event? It downloads it, really. It checks the event blacklist. It handles the distribution downgrade. So if it's a remote server and it's set to distribute to community, then it's downgraded one to saying, okay, local community only, and so forth. So that's the distribution mechanism of MISP. It actually discards empty events, because there was an issue last year about all these empty events popping up, so that's now discarded. And then it checks if the event already exists locally, and if it does, it calls edit, or if it doesn't, it calls add. And if it calls add, it checks also if the organization is blacklisted. So what was the issue with this stuff? It's called from schedule. It's basically the same thing, only from a schedule. So it calls the server pool, but then on a schedule. So what's the issue with the logic? Actually, it was a blacklisting issue. Events are blacklisted either by UUID, which works fine, because it gets that thermostat directly from the index. But you can also blacklist organizations also by UUID. But that's handled in the event add. So that means an event needs to be pulled down first. Then it attempts to add it, and then the logic says, okay, no, we won't add this one because the organization is blacklisted. It was not so bad. It worked for a while. But then this happened. Some people started noticing that the pools started to increase in time. And I created this issue when it was 2 hours and 45 minutes for each pool. And we did that every hour, so that didn't really work out well. So by the time I got to do this deep dive that I'm talking about with you now, it was up to 4 hours. And it was really not workable anymore. Our users started to complain, saying, hey, we used to get data every hour, and now it's only twice a day. What happened? Well, this is what happened. We had 50,000 events on the Circle MISP coming from one organization. Was then 37%. I'm pretty sure it's more than that now. And early on, we decided to blacklist this organization, because we decided we didn't really care for that information. So what happens then? You blacklist by UUID, and they get blacklisted every time it adds. MISP needs to fetch all those 50,000 events individually, and then decide, even individually, no, we do not want this. So that takes about 4 hours. How do we fix this? The interesting part is that when I figured this out, I updated the issue tracker, saying, okay, I figured out what's wrong. We really need the UUID of the organization in that index. That's the efficient way to handle this. So I posted that, started working on the solution. I think it took me, I don't know, 45 minutes or something to code it up. And then I wanted to submit the pull request. And then Andras already did the same thing, much better, much faster. So his code is actually the fix. My code is just discarded, rightfully so. but the solution is pretty simple. You add the UUID of the organization to the index when you pull the index down. That's pretty fast. Then you check for the organization blacklist on that index and not just when you add the event. And then it becomes pretty fast. So that's how we made MISP 500 times faster, because now a pull only takes 28 seconds. So when you did division, it's 514 times faster. So we were very happy with that. Our users were very happy with that. So now that I talked to you about syncing, there's of course more to tell. There's more coming for syncing. Anders is working on syncing sightings at the moment, because right now sightings are only shared when a full event is pushed or pulled. But when there's an update to the sightings, it's not synced. So that's coming soon. And I also heard there's something about syncing reports, which I don't know what they are yet, but I'm sure we'll learn that today. So they're also going to be synced in the future at some point. So another thing that's on my list to do, we get a lot of these ghost updates. It's really nasty because they're updates that don't change anything, but they are pushed and then alert emails are sent out and users get confused. So that's on my to-do list to at least stop this nonsense, but hopefully figure out where it's coming from. Not sure if we have the root cause yet. But at least stop these alert emails from being sent. So that's really my explanation of this issue. Not sure if there's any questions about this. Anyone who wants to know more about how syncing actually works? Yes, Christoph.
Hi, I have two questions actually. You mentioned you are syncing every hour, I guess, and it took 4 hours to sync. So are you now syncing every minute because it syncs like in 20 seconds? Okay. The more serious question. So you looked at performance and speed of different functions and different locations of code. I'd be interested to hear or to know how you identified which section of the code was the relevant one, because that might help as well me as maybe other people in identifying performance issues with code.
I'm really an amateur software developer. I don't really do development environments and debugging function stuff. So what I do when I debug code, I add print statements. So I started adding print statements in all of these functions that I was listing, basically. And then pretty quickly realized that the event add was being called 50,000 times, and my temporary file was growing like crazy. So then that pretty much led me to the what was going on. So it's just a matter of following the logic, seeing, okay, how does the sync work? How is it supposed to work? And then figuring out that it wasn't, the logic was basically flawed. So that's how I did it. Any more questions? My daughter told me that any presentation needs to end with asking for tips and tops. What did I do right? What could I do better? Anyone? No? Oh, thank you.